video, I will be taking you through a gentle yoga flow practice, which is really useful for your first trimester of pregnancy. I am actually currently in my second trimester, but I really wanted to share this sequence with you because it was so useful for me in both of my pregnancies. The sequence is for yoga beginners, so if you're new to yoga, or if you are a regular yoga practitioner, this sequence will help you to learn to slow down and let go, because it is really important that we do start to do that, especially in the first trimester. And it's also important that you don't start any kind of new kind of poses or practices, just stick to what you already know in your yoga practice. In the first trimester, your body is doing so much. You are creating a baby and you're also creating the placenta. So you will feel deep exhaustion. So in this sequence, we really work on allowing ourselves to relax and let go and allowing time and space for us to rest. Sleep is going to be the most important thing for the development of your baby in the first trimester. So this sequence will really help you to allow space to just sleep, to rest, to let go and feel relaxed in the body and in the mind. Also in the first trimester, there are a lot of emotional changes, your hormones are changing, you might also experience a lot of nausea. So this sequence will really help to ground your body and your mind so that you can really start to now deal with all the changes that will be happening within your body. So let's get started with the practice. To begin our practice, we'll come down into a seated position. If you want to use a cushion or a block, then just allow yourself to rest the hips down onto that cushion or block and allow yourselves to get comfortable. And then from here, we'll either rest the hands in the knees or in the lap and just allowing your eyes to gently close. From here now, just taking a moment to close off the external world and to come into this space of connecting to your body, your breath, and connecting to your baby. So to begin with, allow your awareness and attention to come all the way down into your hips and into your legs. Take a moment to feel the ground and the earth beneath you. Now draw your awareness and attention onto the base of the spine and allow your attention to move along your spine into the neck. Relax your shoulders and just become aware of your arms, the bend at the elbows and the connection of the hands to the lap or to the knees. Take a moment to rest your awareness into the palms of the hands and just feeling the energy and the tingling sensation into the palms of the hands. The chin is parallel to the ground and the face is soft. The eyes are closed and the awareness is inward. From here now, just taking your attention into your breath, take a moment to find the breath within the body. And then from here, just allowing a long, slow, deep breath in through the nose and out through the mouth. Again, breathing deeply in and out. One more slow breath in and out. And just allow your breath to settle, allow your mind and attention to settle. And here now, just taking your hands and resting them on your belly and just taking a few moments to connect to your baby, knowing that here within your body, you are creating a baby. And knowing that with your breath, as you breathe in your practice, you're breathing in for two. So from here, just taking a moment, just mentally within your mind, to offer any words that you wish to the baby. And then once again, taking a breath in for you and your baby. And exhale fully. And gently allow your eyes to open. From this position now, we're going to come into a wide stance, child's pose. So here you're going to come towards the back of your mat and you can just allow your knees to go wide for your toes to touch And if you want to keep that cushion, actually, you can keep the cushion down in front of you and you can rest on the cushion like this, or you can even take the cushion underneath your hips and just sit on the cushion. And then from here, we're just going to rest the head down. And we're going to take a few moments to hold this position. So once again, just allowing your body to settle, to feel your hips coming down towards the heels, to feel that opening into the armpits and the chest just dropping down towards the ground. Once again, just allow a long, slow, deep breath in and out. Again, inhale and exhale. One more deep breath in and out. And just feel the breath just return back to its own natural pattern. And just feeling the rise and the fall of your back as you inhale and exhale. From here now, we'll start to raise the gaze up and we'll start to take the hands out in front of us. So here now, just walking the hands up the mat, opening up through the armpits and down through the sides of the body. And just continue to look towards the top of your mat. And just feeling the sides of the body opening up. From here now, we'll lift the hips up and just adjust the position of the hands as you come into cat pose. So the wrists are underneath the shoulders and the knees are underneath the hips. From here, we'll start to work into the cat-cow stretch. So lowering your tailbone down, draw the belly up, hugging the baby towards you, separating through the shoulder blades and dropping through the neck and the head. And then as you inhale, take your tailbone up towards the ceiling, drop through the belly, and lifting up through the head and the chest. And then from here again, as you exhale, rounding out your spine. And inhale to invert that stretch. Exhale, closing. And inhale to open. Continue with that for a few more rounds, just allowing your spine to open up a vertebra at a time. And then we'll just come into a neutral position and we'll start to just work the arms. So you're going to take your right hand underneath the left. Just stretch that hand away from you as the head comes down. So just feeling a gentle twist into your shoulder and down through the arm. Take a moment to hold and again just notice the flow of your breath. And then from here gently come back through to center and over to the other side. So taking the left hand underneath the right, just stretch that hand away from you. And just feel that opening into the shoulder, a light twist here. And then once again, gently coming back through to center. From here now, we'll take the knees closer together and we're going to just take the right foot back, just draw the toes under and push the heel away. And just feel that stretch in through the back of the leg. From here now, take a breath in. As you exhale, you're going to lift that right leg up and then down, but don't let it touch the mat. So inhale up, exhale down, inhale up, exhale down, inhale up, and just exhale here. So continue to hold. And just really pointing through the toes, stretching that foot away from you and lengthening through that right leg. And then from here, we'll raise the left hand up in line with the left shoulder. So coming into your tiger stretch, just feeling that balance. And then from here, we'll release the left hand down, bringing that right knee back in with the left knee. Over to the other side, so take the left foot back, draw the toes under and push that heel away. And just feeling that stretch in through the back of the leg. And then from here, once again, just take a breath in. As you exhale, just lifting that back foot up. And then exhale down, inhale up, exhale down. Continue with that for a couple of rounds, just working through the left side. And then the next time that left leg is raised, we'll hold it there, point through the toes, lengthen through the leg, and then just taking that right hand up in line with the right shoulder, lengthening through the fingers, and take your gaze either to look up, or you can look directly down, whatever's most comfortable for the neck. Notice the flow of the breath, and then gently releasing back down. Again, just allow the knees to be hip width apart, and take a moment once again to arch the back. From here now, just coming into a neutral position with the spine. Once again, take the knees together. We'll come to gate pose.
So you're going to step your right foot out to the side, and then we're going to start to raise the right hand up towards the ceiling and just really stretching through the fingers, lengthening that hand up, keeping the fingers together and just looking beyond the fingers. Take a moment to hold it and feel yourself just breathing into that right rib cage. Here, even if you need to do big deep breaths in through the nose, out through the mouth, just allow yourself to do so that you can feel the flow of the breath in the body as you hold. And then from here, we'll gently start to release coming down and just bringing that right knee in. From here, over to the other side, so taking the left foot all the way back behind you and just raising that left hand up towards the ceiling and just feeling that stretch again through the left side. And again, allow that breath to move into the left rib cage and the left side of the body. And then from here, we'll gently release, coming all the way down and just bringing that left knee in. From here now, we'll start to move into puppy dog. So you're going to take your hands a little bit higher up the mat, and then you're going to start to just lower your chest down, taking your hips up nice and high. Connect your forehead towards the ground. So just notice the difference here between this and child's pose. This is just a opening, a heart center opening. So here, the heart center and the chest can open. We can start to connect to that feeling of love, unconditional love, and that love that we have for our baby. So just take a moment holding. Notice the flow of the breath. Continue to hold. Just feel the flow of the breath. Feel the chest dropping down towards the ground. And then from here, just looking up and just walking your hands back into that cat position. And we'll start to work with our figure of eights here now. So you're going to take your hips all the way down and over towards your right foot. Allow the hips to come towards the left foot. Coming up towards your right hand, to the left hand, back down and around. So just moving as though you were drawing a figure of eight on your mat. And just allowing your body to flow. You can move here with the breath and just allow big deep breaths in and out. And here, even if you want to just slightly invert and arch the spine, you can do that too. And just allowing energy to flow through the body. And then we'll reverse that movement. So taking your hips down towards your left foot, towards the right foot, to the left hand, to the right hand, and around. So just big circles there. Continue with that for just another few more moments. And then from here, just gently, just bringing yourself back through to center. And once again, just take a moment at center to arch the spine, to separate through the shoulder blades. And then to just gently start to invert that stretch. Then from here, just moving back into a neutral spine, and we'll take a moment once again just to rest down into that extended child's pose. And just take a moment there in your extended child. And then from this child's pose, we will start to just come up with the upper body, just coming through into Vajrasana. And then we're going to start to transition into a standing position. And this, the way that we're going to come through to standing, is going to be quite useful for you to know as you start to get bigger in the second trimester and the third trimester. So here we want to place the hands down on the ground, lift your hips up, draw your toes under, and then you're going to lift your knees up and away from you. lower your heels down as your hands come in. So you're coming through almost like a standing forward bend, but here you can take a bend through the knees. And then you're just going to start to just uncurl your spine as you come all the way through to a standing. And then as you come to the top, just take a few moments to roll the shoulders back. And we're going to take a moment now to come into tree pose. So from here, just allow your feet to be hip width apart. And I'm going to face this way so that you can see. And then really allow yourself to lift up all the toes, to spread the toes, to ground them down into your mat. And from here, just take a moment to take a deep breath in. Exhale, sigh the breath out of the mouth. This time, breathe in and draw your awareness into the feet all the way up through the body. Exhale through the mouth. Once more, breathe into the feet as if you're drawing energy from the earth, from the ground, all the way up. And then exhale through the mouth. Take a moment to find your drishti, so a point to focus on with your eyes as we start to work into a balance. So you're going to take your hands onto your hips, and we're going to start to just raise the right foot up onto the standing left leg. So from here, just take a moment to hold, and you're lightly squeezing into your left glutes. And you're just going to open that hip up, so you're going to draw the right knee back. Try not to rotate your hips though, your hips are still facing the top of the mat. And then from here, if you wish, you can then just take your hands into a prayer position at the chest, just resting the thumbs at the chest. Take a moment to hold, and then we'll gently release and move over to the other side. So the right foot is down. We'll take the left foot up onto the standing right lower leg. And again, we're just drawing that knee back, just opening up through the hips, lightly squeezing into the right glute. And then just taking your hands into that prayer position at the chest. Keep the eyes steady and focused on your drishti. And again, just take a few moments to hold. And then from here, just gently releasing down. And then we'll go back onto it on the left side, but this time see if you can take your foot a little bit higher. So here we can take the foot right up into the thigh, if that feels comfortable. Otherwise, just keep it on the lower leg, if you'd rather just stay soft in the pose. And then from here, if you wish, you can then even just take your hands up towards the ceiling and just stretching the prayer hands all the way up and just opening up through the armpits and through the sides of the body. Notice the flow of the breath. And then just bringing your hands back to heart and lowering that right foot down over to the other side. So now just bringing your left foot all the way up into that standing right leg. And again here, just taking the hands through to that prayer position at the heart. And extending the hands all the way up towards the ceiling, really just lifting up through the rib cage, the sides of the body, creating space for the body. Take a moment to hold. And then once again, just bringing the hands back towards the heart and gently releasing that left foot down. From here, we can relax your hands, take a moment, shake it out through the legs. And then we're going to come towards the back of the mat once again, and then we're going to come back down onto the ground. So from here, again, you can take your hands onto your hips and you can take a little bend through the knees and to come down. So I'm going to show you the transition to come down, which is going to be useful as your baby starts to grow. So here you can take your hands onto your thighs, almost coming through a squat, and perhaps we'll just take a moment to hold the squat and just feel like the thighs engaging. You can just allow a little bit of movement here. Just opening up through the chest, allow the breath to flow. And then from here, just taking the hands down to the mat, walk the hands up the mat. As you lower your knees down, and we're going to come back into Vajrasana. So here, just resting your hands on your thighs. Take a slow deep breath in and out. And here, we're going to take the hands onto the belly towards the baby and just take a moment just to connect to the baby and allowing a deep breath in for you and your baby. And exhale fully. And then from here, we'll start to just release the legs, taking the feet up. And once again, I'm just going to turn to face you. And I'm going to come into butterfly pose. So as you come into butterfly pose, you're connecting the soles of your feet together, taking the knees wide. And we're going to take a moment here to take our thumbs on the insides of the feet and to open the feet up as if you were like opening up a book. So here, just lightly just pressing into the feet to open the feet up, and almost like massaging the feet. So just a light massage here into the soles of your feet, and just allowing that sense of touch for the body. And then we'll take a moment to hold, and we'll work with a little bit of butterfly. So here, just lifting the knees up and down, feeling that stretch through the inner thighs and the hips. And just take a few moments here with your breath too. You can work with some deep breaths in and out. And then we'll take a moment to hold, just keeping nice and tall through the spine. And then from here, we'll start to move into Jainamistrypatel. And here I'll actually mirror you in this part of the practice. So if you lift up through your right knee and extend your right leg all the way out and bring your left foot in towards you. So here in Jainamistrypatel, generally we might want to avoid forward bends because obviously it's going to constrict into the belly area. But I actually really enjoy forward bends. As long as you keep an open spine and almost like a straight back, you'll be able to really just enjoy the stretch as well as creating space for the baby. So it's really important here that we flex through the foot and keep the upper body nice and tall. We don't want to round out into the spine. So from here, take a breath in. As you exhale, you can take your hands down your legs towards your lower leg, ankle, or if you can reach the toes, go for the toes. But here, we're keeping the spine open and we're looking up. So try not to look down, try not to hunch your shoulders or round out your back in any way whatsoever. And then just working with your breath. So deep breath in and out. And each time you exhale, just feeling yourself just moving a little bit deeper into the stretch. Now, if you find that you're a little bit tight in your forward bend, you might want to sit on a cushion or a couple of blocks just to lift the hips up. You might even want to take a little bit of a bend into the knee. But again, just make sure you do have space for the belly area. We don't want to cause any constriction into the belly. But again, just allowing the breath to take you deeper into the stretch. And once again, I encourage you to keep looking up, looking towards your toes. And then from here, we'll gently start to release as we come all the way back up. And we'll just switch over to the other side. So now just taking the left leg out, bringing the right foot in. And just extending and flexing through that left foot. Once again, nice and tall with your upper body. Take a deep breath in, and then exhale, coming down into the stretch, reaching for the leg, the ankle, or the foot. And once again, we'll take a few moments to hold. And really just working with your breath to ease yourself down into the stretch. And it's also important here not to overstretch. So your body's a little bit more open when you're pregnant. Everything's starting to soften and open up. But we don't want to overdo anything. So just allow yourself to move deeper into the pose with your exhale. We're not forcing anything. Continue to listen to your body. Holding the stretch, feeling the breath flowing through the body. And then from here, we'll gently start to soften as we come all the way back up. And then we'll take a moment to come into butterfly once again. So again, just connecting the soles of the feet together. And again, just lifting the knees up and down. And then from this position here, we're going to take ourselves into the legs up the wall, okay? So this is a really nice way to relax the legs and also great to do in your first trimester when you can lie on your back as well. So here, you're going to get nice and close to the wall and also grab like cushions if you need to support yourself in this pose. So from here, lift, get your hips really nice and close to the wall and then lift your legs up nice and high. And from here, lowering the spine down to the ground, and then you can place that cushion underneath your head. And here we're going to just rest the hands on the baby. So just connecting to the belly area. Keep the legs relaxed, the feet relaxed. We'll take a few moments to hold. And just feeling the blood just flowing down the legs, feeling that release into the feet. And we'll also just work with the breath. So here we're going to work with the golden thread breath. So you're going to breathe in through the nose. Allow your lips to part softly and exhale ever so gently out of the mouth. Breathing deeply in. Exhale really softly out of the mouth. And just continue with that for a few rounds. Really just encouraging that exhalation to lengthen. Continue for just another moment. You can close the eyes. Just feel that awareness being inwards and just allowing the space and time to relax and to let go. And then after your next exhalation, we'll release the control of the breath. Just allow the breath to come back into its own pattern. And then we'll take a moment to just bend into the knees and to turn onto the left side of the body. Remaining here for a moment and then just pushing up back into a seated, and then we will come into a complete lying down position. So I'm going to show you how to get down and how to support yourself in your lying down position, and then I'm going to sit up through the practice as I guide you through your relaxation. So again, you might want a cushion underneath the head, and you might also want to take a cushion underneath your knees to support your lower back. So here I'm just grabbing my cushion and just taking it underneath the knees. We'll just support that lower back area. And you want to go nice and wide with your feet, supporting the knees, and then just taking the spine all the way down. Coming all the way down, resting the head now onto the cushion and taking your hands wide with the palms facing upwards. So just take a few moments, get yourself into that position. I'm going to sit up for this part of the practice because now that I'm in my second trimester, I don't really like lying on my back for so long. And actually, after about 30 weeks, you don't want to lie on your back at all. So we then will adjust our position, and I'll show you that in my next video where I'll take you through the second trimester practice. But otherwise, get yourself really comfortable in your relaxation, and I'll guide you through a short relaxation here so that your body can just really unwind. So from here again, the feet are about hip width apart, the hands are away from the body with the palms facing up, and the eyes are closed. And as we come into this position, just take a long, slow, deep breath in through the nose. Exhale and sigh the breath out fully from the mouth. Again, breathing deeply in and out. One more slow breath in and out. And just feeling your breath settle, feeling your mind and attention settle too. And just knowing that as you rest here, you are supported by the ground underneath you. You are lying on the earth, Mother Earth. So just allow yourself to let go, to rest. And to know that here your body is still working, that even though you're resting and relaxing, you're still creating within your own body. So just allow your body to do whatever it needs to do here. You don't need to think about the process. You just need to allow it to happen, to give it space, to nurture the child that is within you. So let's take a moment to really just relax the entire body, and we're just going to take our mind and awareness around the body. So drop your attention down into your feet and relax the soles of your feet. Relax the top of your feet and all the toes. Relax your ankles and the lower legs, the knees and the thighs. Feel the weight of your hips sinking down towards the ground and drawing your attention along your spine into the neck. Relax the muscles in your back and notice the shoulder blades against the ground. Relax your belly and allow your baby this space and time to relax. Relax into your chest and into your heart center. Relax into your upper arms, your elbows and your lower arms. Relax the wrists, the hands, the fingers and the fingertips. Relax your head and your face and allow yourself to drop all expression from the face. To feel the lips parting, the jaw dropping, the mouth relaxing. Relax your cheeks and your cheekbones, your ears and your nose, your eyes, the eyelids, the eyebrows, the forehead and the top of the head. And just take a moment here for your entire body to relax. In a very short moment, we'll start to come out of this relaxation. To begin with, just start to notice your surroundings once again, just recognizing the sounds that you can hear around you. Take a moment to feel the back of your body against the ground, to notice that sense of touch and your clothes against your skin. Feel the flow of your breath as you now start to invite a deep breath in for you and your baby, and exhaling fully. Again, breathing deeply in and out. One more slow breath in and out. Relax your breath. Allow it to move back into its own natural pattern as you take your awareness now down your arms and your legs, bringing movements to your fingers and your toes. Start to rotate your wrists and your ankles. Bring your hands closer to the sides of the body and the feet closer together again. And take some time here to stretch your body out however you need. And then from here, just drawing the knees in towards the chest, just hug the knees as you then come to rest onto one side of the body. Use your hands now to just push into the ground to bring yourself back into this seated position. And once again, we'll just take a moment here with the eyes closed, the awareness inwards, and just feeling the energy of this practice. And again, just taking a moment to rest your hands on your belly and connecting to your baby. And just taking a moment in this quiet space to offer any words that you wish to your baby. Take a slow deep breath in and out. And gently allow your eyes to open. So as you come back into the room, just allow yourselves to take things easy as you return back to your day. And I hope you enjoyed this practice, and it would be great to hear how you feel. So please do leave me a comment in the comments below. Please also subscribe to this channel if you haven't done so already, so that you can receive notifications of when I upload a new video. And also, I will be so grateful if you could share this video with any other pregnant women out there who might benefit from this practice. I look forward to seeing you here next time, and namaste.